Sure. Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining me on another episode of 24 News with Kuhle. Today I'm honored to welcome our guest, Tebogo Hlulane, aka Messi, who is currently on loan at Maritzburg United from Orlando Pirates. How's it?
Good yourself, my man.
Good. So, how's lockdown been for you?
Lockdown. You know, there's no specific way of saying how it's been. It's just how you take it. You know, other people will say it's been good. Other people say it's been frustrating. But for me, it's been frustrating because, you know, we can't be doing what we love. And, you know, it's very difficult. But I guess we have to live with the whole situation. There's not much we can do. It's out of our control. But in terms of how it's been, it's been really difficult. It's something we have to adjust to.
So basically, now that you have been during lockdown now, can I ask, what have you been doing with the boys in terms of online training? How has that been? I know it's been difficult. Most people say it has been. But so do you think it's better online training than training on the field for you, your own perspective?
Obviously, training with the guys, it's much more better physically. You know, online, it's very difficult because, you know, you don't get much joy from that, you know. And, you know, when you're on the field with everyone, that's where we get much joy. So it was difficult, to be honest, because I think we weren't used to training online or via Zooms, via all these video calls, you know. We weren't used to such things, so. You know, at times that when you do a Zoom, you don't have the energy as you'd have when you're training because you wake up, you take a bath, or if you don't, and then you switch off your phone, and then you train via phone. So sometimes you don't have much energy because it doesn't have the same drive as it would have if you're on the field. So for me, I prefer actually training with the guys. I think I can attest to all soccer players. We would rather be on the field than doing a Zoom meeting.
So where did your love for soccer all start?
For as long as I can remember, I can't give you a year or a time. You know, I've always loved the game. So the game has always been something that I always wanted to do, be it even before I became a professional, because, you know, I've always been playing. So From being a youngster growing up, I've always wanted to be part of the game, and to get the opportunity to play the game professional was just a dream come true for me. So, you know, I've always loved the game for as long as I remember. I can't tell you from a certain age, but since small, you know, I've always been playing, from playing street football to playing in the PSL. So it's been a long love story for me with the game.
Being out on loan for 2 years out of your contract with Orlando Pirates, what have you learned when it comes to improving your own skills and yourself as a person, from going to Chipa United to Maritzburg United? What have you learned during those 2 years?
Well, obviously, as a player, you learn more of yourself when you're playing. You know, so when I moved from Cosmos to Chipa, I started to know more about myself as a person, as a player, and the type of player that I can be. And from Chipa to Pirates, I also learned to be a different type of player. Different types of player, different types of situations. You learn a lot through those moments. So, and moving to Maritzburg also, you know, I learned a lot about myself also again. So each move that I made in my career has been one that's taught me a lot about myself and as a footballer. But more as a footballer, because I know I can offer a lot, you know. So I know that I still have a long way to go, and I still have a long way to sort of learn more about myself. So, you know, it's a learning curve. So I take each moment as it's come, obviously. I don't premeditate or pre-plan things, you know. I always take it as it comes. So each challenge that comes to me or at me, I take it on as it comes, you know. I don't pre-plan it, you know, because you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. So each challenge that comes sort of as a surprise for me. But how you deal with it shows your mental strength. So, you know, I was able to grow my mental strength as well. Obviously, being on loan, sometimes when you go on loan, we as players react differently. So some player will take it as he's not a good player or he's not wanted at the current team. But for me, I took it as a positive thing. I'm going to play. That's the most important thing for me, to be on the pitch and to play. The rest I so wanna after, but I wanna enjoy myself for, because as a footballer, you want to play. Whether it's 10 minutes, whether it's 20 minutes, you want to play. So the more you play, you learn more about yourself as a player and as a person.
So how difficult has it been for you to adjust, okay, for let's say for the last 4 seasons, because you've been at Jomo, you've been at Pirates, you've been at Chipa, you've been at Maritzburg. How difficult has it been for you to adjust to a team almost every year, a new team every year, with new faces and everyone?
Yeah, you know, funny enough, I had this conversation with someone, I think yesterday, about me not having much stability, you know? I mean, I moved from Joburg to Port Elizabeth, back to Joburg, now to Maritzburg. So for me, it's been a roller coaster. But that roller coaster, it's taught me a lot about myself, and it's grown me, to be honest. And you know, the more you know, I can say comfortably that when I moved to Chipa, I didn't know what to expect. It's a new province. I've never been there before, and it was my first time playing out of the province. But I got to Chipa, and Chipa's like my second home now. I can call someone and fly down to Chipa. I'll have accommodation. So you learn more about the place as well. You learn more about the people, and you become one of them. So I became a Port Elizabeth player and a person, because you know I can call someone from PE. A lot of people, they'll say ubuyanin. You learn more about the language as well. Obviously, moving back to Joburg, I'm not foreign to Joburg. Joburg is the place I've been born, so it's all about now readjusting back to Joburg. Coming back to Maritzburg, you learn more people, you learn more about the place, and you know I can't really complain, because you know it's taught me a lot. And through distance, you find peace. So I found a lot of peace in moving. I learned more about myself, so it hasn't been really difficult. Okay, first few stages of it, it becomes really tricky. But coming to Maritzburg, I think it was pretty simple for me, because, you know, I think it was something that my heart also desired, because of being able to come play. So my heart was at ease. But moving to PE was the more difficult one, because it was my first time leaving Joburg and playing in a different province. So it was a bit of a tricky one, but by the time the ball started rolling, everything just became easy for me.
So with you playing for under Eric Tinkler, rather, how was your emotion when you found out that you're playing under such a, you're going to get coached by one of the greatest South African footballers of all time, Eric Tinkler?
Yeah, obviously, when he came to I think my first time I worked with him was at Chipa. He came in after Coach Dan had left. And at the time, you know, it was a time where the team wasn't doing too well. And we knew the caliber of a coach that's coming. But, you know, he gave us a lot of confidence. You know, he didn't want to change us. And I think I was one of the luckiest players, because from the time he came in, I started to play. You know, I carried on playing. Nothing changed. And he used to speak to me a lot about my career going forward. He had so much faith in me. And I think that's why coming back to Maritzburg, working with him, you know, it's been pretty simple for me, because I think he knows the type of player I am, and he knows the type of person I am, and I know him as well. So it became easy, you know. And, you know, he's a great coach. Obviously, working with him before made it easy for me to come here and work with him again.
How difficult has it been, do you believe you have ticked all the boxes when it comes to you trying to get back to Orlando Pirates next season as part of the starting 11? Do you believe?
Well, if I'm honest to myself,
sorry?
If I'm honest to myself, for me, coming to Maritzburg wasn't about me ticking boxes for Pirates. It's about getting back on the field and playing. So, you know, some other things you can control, some other things you can't control. So I can't control whether I'll be in the starting lineup, whether I'll be at Pirates playing, whether I won't be playing. That's things that's out of my control. But my control is working hard, playing hard, and enjoying myself, you know. You know, Pirates has got great calibers of players. I don't even want to mention, because we all know the type of players they have. So But provided I get the opportunity to play, I'll grab it with both hands. But at the end of the day, for me, it was just about playing, not really ticking boxes, because I don't want to put too much emphasis on me trying to prove that I'm good enough to play at Pirates. No, for me, it was about enjoying myself, being on the field, because that's what I love. That's what I love. You know, I love playing. And the only competition I have is the competition with myself. You know, I'm only in competition with myself. I don't want to be in competition with other people. I look at other persons. You know? I look at myself first. I look at what I can do. And the rest follows itself, to be honest. So provided I get the chance at Pirates, obviously I'll take it at both ends. I'll find much joy. It's a big team, and everyone wants to play for a big team. But the honest truth is that we're not all going to play at the same time. So you have to trust the processes of whatever happens in your career. So for me, it's just about, you know, working hard, playing, getting as much game time as I can wherever I play. But provided I get the game time in private, the Pirates, to be honest, then I'll take it at both ends.
So you've been regarded as one of the most successful loaned out players from Pirates, with an 8 out of 10 rating from kickoff.com for your spell this season. How did you achieve this success to be regarded as one of the most successful players that have been loaned out of Pirates, considering that there are about six to seven of you that are at your caliber that have been loaned out to other various PSL teams?
For me, it was mental strength. You know, it was waiting for your moment to play. You know, I think during the time I was at Pirates, I had a decision to make. I wasn't playing. So I had a decision to make. Am I going to blame the world, blame everyone that I'm not playing, sulk? Or am I just going to continue to work hard? If I do get a loan, I have to be ready. So I was ready for the loan deal. My heart was open to the loan deal because I just wanted to be on the field, you know. And coming here also, to be honest, the Maritzburg players, I think all of them, even the guys that weren't playing, the guys that were playing, they welcomed me as if I've been here from the start of the season. So by the time I went on the field, it just felt like I was here. So it became so easy for me, you know. But I think for me, it was all about my mental strength. I was prepared to work as if I'm a Maritzburg player. Not necessarily saying I'm coming from loan and I deserve to play or I must play. No, 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 no. And, you know, Coach Eric made it clear to me. You come here as a Maritzburg player, you're gonna work as hard as they work here. You're not going to come here with an attitude that you deserve to play. And that's the type of attitude I have. I want to work for the team I'm playing for. So, you know, I just got on the field and I started to enjoy myself. And, you know, it became successful, but I was very happy with how I managed to adjust to the team or to adjust to the loan.
What ways do you believe the PSL can improve the standard of soccer in our country, considering that our league is ranked 31st in the world?
I personally think the way it's going to improve is that we enhance youngsters. I think youngsters need to come in more. I mean, 16-year-olds are making debuts in La Liga. 15-year-olds are making debuts in La Liga. 20-year-olds are winning World Cup. So the future of our country lays in our youngsters. Our youngsters need to be gracing the PSL rankings. They need to be playing, because at the end of the day, if you look at the crops of our big name players, they get into the ages of 30, and at 30 already your legs are starting to run out. So we need to enhance the youngsters coming up, to be honest, because they hold our future. And I think if we not really copy, but if we just pay attention to how teams abroad do it, they will introduce 7-8 youngsters in their team. I mean, I watched the first game of the lockdown in the Premier League. A 16-year-old, 17-year-old from Everton, Gordon, he made his debut against Liverpool in a difficult match where Liverpool is chasing the league. Everton is chasing the top 8. So, but it proved that the coaches have firm belief in their players. So it doesn't matter of the name that's on the bench or the name that's in the team. But if you believe in the youngsters, then, you know, I think they will come to the party. So for me, I honestly believe that we're not far off from abroad. Obviously, tactically, we can improve, but that's something that we have to use our strength. I always say that if I'm a player, I need to know my strength. So if I know that I'm a skillful player. I need to use it to my advantage. I'm not gonna pass the way Uneima passing a con, but I can only pass the way I pass. So I used to use my strength, you know. So I think we need to focus more on that, not become predictable. I think we become too predictable at times. We're trying to play a certain way that we don't know how to play. But if we look back in the years from the likes of Skara Ngobeze, how he used to play, he used to go on the field, he used to enjoy himself, and he plays the way he plays. And that's how teams are successful. But I firmly believe that if teams, you know, pay attention to youngsters in our country and they give them the chance, then I think we'll do well. But, you know, again, we can only do so much. So it's only up to them. But I believe that our rankings can get better, but our youngsters hold our future. Because even the under-23s, they qualified for the Olympics. So that shows you that we've got talent everywhere. It just needs to be out there. It needs to be shown. The world needs to see our talent.
So do you believe in South Africa having VAR? Well, for PSL, do you believe that the PSL needs to introduce technology like VAR and goal line technology to improve referee decisions?
I don't think so. I think the VAR, I think one thing that I have negative about VAR, it stops the momentum of the game. You know, those 3-4 minutes that you have to stop, you become flat. And I think you can ask any footballer. 2 minutes of waiting, you know, you have to get warm again. Especially if you're a team that was attacking the other team. Now you have to stop. Now you have to start again. And also, I think, honestly, it's not good enough because there's going to be many fights. As said, South Africans, we're not scared to get out. So I believe that in that regard, I don't think VAR would work in our country. I think sometimes it's good, yeah, for the team, yes, we want to make things fair, but we should let football be natural. We shouldn't make football a technology. It's not a technology. You can't play football with a computer. You need to let the guys go on the field and play. So for me, I believe, I would say no. Maybe other people would say yes, but I believe for me, no, because some other decisions VAR, you can see penalty, yes, sometimes it's not, you know, so it's debatable. But for me, I think VAR is not the one. You should just let the football flow.
So, with the season set to resume next month, or well, close to the end of this month and early next month, what are your plans going into, well, finishing the rest of the season? That's how do you want to improve?
Obviously, we have teams' aspirations. We want to first qualify for the top 8, so we need 3 points to do that. And our first game is against Leopards, so we want to ensure that we win that game to make certain that we qualify for top 8. So we win that game, then we guarantee top 8. And then after that, it's all about us enjoying ourselves because, you know, the team, we've got really great players. So obviously there'll be a lot of rotation, but the first things first is for us to qualify for top 8. And then where we finish is only up to us, but we want to finish in the top 8 and as high as possible as we can finish. But for us, it's just to get to top 8. And then obviously there'll be a lot of rotations in the team, but you know, the primary goal that coach has emphasized is win your first game, secure top 8, and then we can start enjoying ourselves. So I think the more if we win the first game, then the other games will play with less pressure, more confidence, and we'll just enjoy ourselves, you know.
So can I ask, let me take this back a little bit. You used to play for Jomo Cosmos. Can I ask, how was that transition from playing for NFD and stepping up to a PSL level? That, what difficulties have you faced as yourself? Not maybe your other most people, but as yourself, as a player, what were those difficulties that stepping up from GLAAD Africa Championship well now to the PSL? What are those difficulties that you have to face in terms of the standard of play and all sorts?
I think the biggest challenge for me was when I was at Cosmos, I was playing as a winger, right winger, straight winger. And when I moved to Chipa, obviously I got signed as a winger. But when I looked at the players that were there, you know, and it was not in my control. But I can name them. When I got there, I was like, the sixth winger or seventh winger, you know. And at that time, Chipa had signed 13 players, obviously all around, but I was one of the 13. But in the wing positions, you had Thabo Rakgale. We all know Thabo Rakgale. There was Mark Mayambela. There was Mbokoma. There was the two guys from Botswana. There was Bentley. So I was like the sixth winger. And the difficult decision that it sort of also, I lost a bit of confidence, I won't lie. But at the end of the day, when I look at it today, it made me stronger. Coach Dan wanted to play me as a left back. So I'd never played left back in my life. Not at training, not at tournaments, not professional. I'd never played left back in my life. So, you know, he tried something. He told me that if I don't play left back, I'm probably not going to play. So I'm thinking, okay, I just signed a professional contract with Chipa. You know, PSL, you want to don the PSL, you want to play in the PSL. And I moved from Joburg to Port Elizabeth. You know, I wanna play. So obviously, I wasn't naive about the situation. I asked for advice from people that played left back. One was Paseka Marco, because he was the left back at Chipa and moved to Pirates. So I had a conversation with him, and he said, you'll do well. And after that, played few friendlies. Obviously, positioning for me was bad. I was lost at first, but it got better. To a point where I made my debut against Bloemfontein Celtic. So, you know, I was still a bit lost. Then our second game, I remember, was against Pirates. We lost that one as well. I was a bit lost. But from the time Eric Tinkler came in, you know, he had a talk with me. He said, I know you're not a left back, but I believe that you can dominate in this position because you have the energy to go up and down, down and up. And, you know, I use that to my advantage as well. And I don't look back at it because, you know, as a left back, I think I played all the games. I only missed the last game of the league due to suspension. But I played 34 out of 35 games. I scored 3 goals, got a few assists. So, you know, for me, it worked out. Fear became something that I overcame. And it actually became something that obviously got me signed by Pirates, but also grew me as a person, as a player. So that was the only biggest challenge for me.
Could you share with our viewers and how you got the nickname Messi?
Messi came, I think I was in grade 11 or grade 12. So I'm from Katlehong in Joburg, you know, K1. So there used to be, I didn't have a team at that time, you know. I was still in school, so I didn't have a development team. So I was just that guy freelancing or just playing tournament games, playing top fours, you know. And there was a Sunday I got a call from my older brother to come to my grand's place, because there's a game going on, the top four, you know. So I went, and as I got there, there's a team from Katlehong or from my area, I'm sure, called Squazing, you know. And one of the guys that's playing for Ajax Cape Town now, Thabo Msadi, he was playing. So we grew up in the same area. And they started the game, but I got there, you know, when the game was on. And they were losing 2-0. Okay, so at the time, when it was halftime, I was sitting there outside. And then he came to me, like, how about you, Lalam Fit? I was like, yeah, I want to play. And then he's like, let me talk to these guys. So one thing about top fours or teams, everyone is the coach. So if they don't know you, they won't vouch for you. But Msadi was vouching, like, play this boy, trust. So the team was losing 2-0, and then they put me on. And then, you know, as soon as I got the ball, I just started to go through people. And then we won the game 5-2. I scored 2 goals and I created one. So one of the two guys that called me Messi for the first time, they both passed away. So as I started dribbling through people, the one guy was like, hello, who little bambino? They first used to call me little bambino because I had a small frame. But then the other one was like, hello, who Messi means? And then from then on, it just grew from me playing there to playing tournaments, to playing at the AOS, to playing at Cosmos, to playing at Pirates, to playing at Chipa, and now at Marisburg. So It's even like a daily name now. You know, someone calls me Messi. I don't even get called by my first name anymore. So it's something that just stuck by me. So yeah.
Lastly, what's your advice to all the young boys and girls that want to make soccer a career as well?
I think they should first, before I advise them, they should ask themselves, is that something they want to do? And then they should know that sometimes when it comes to playing soccer, you can't have the best of both worlds. So you can't have soccer and then have lifestyle, for example. You got to sacrifice something. If you want to play football, you got to sacrifice a lot. You got to sacrifice sometimes having time out, you know, with friends, or, you know, you got to give yourself that time for football, because it takes up your daily life, basically. Monday to Monday, you're at training, so you can't have an in-between. And, you know, you got to give yourself the time. You know, time is very important. So the more time you spend playing soccer, is the more time you understand what you want. So you got to know that you got to sacrifice. You can't play football having both lives, lifestyle and football. It's not going to work out. It's going to catch up with you. But you got to sacrifice. For me, I honestly believe that you got to sacrifice a lot, because that was one thing I did. I sacrificed friends. I sacrificed going out. And I love going out. I love dancing. But sometimes you need to understand, if you have goals, you set goals for yourself and you want to reach them, then you've got to sacrifice a lot of stuff. So I made those sacrifices, and today I really don't look back at it. I don't regret it at all. It's been something that I think was best for me to sacrifice.
Thanks a lot for joining us on today's episode of 24 Music Kuhle. Thanks to the viewers as well. If the viewers could be kind enough to follow our channel, follow us on 24 Music Kuhle on YouTube, as well as follow my Instagram account at @_Masego. Thanks a lot for joining us, Tebogo. Have a good one.
It's a pleasure. Good one, my man.